Everyone has their own story to tell, and everyone has experiences that differ from others. Think of a time in your life when something memorable happened, and pause it. This memory becomes a picture with no motion, yet it can still describe the memory the same way as if it were a video. This is a story about two characters, X and Y. X is the timekeeper, the rhythm, the continuous beat of the drum. Y is the developer, the creator, and the dancer. When both harmonize, they are a function of natural artwork, creating the most romantic of graphs. For example, y equals x to the 0 over 0 factorial shows an infinite straight horizontal line. However, what was once considered an infinite line is actually a bunch of points all tied together. Another graph is y equals negative x squared over 2 factorial. Again, when looking at this function closely, it contains a bizarre amount of points. The next graph is x to the 4 over 4 factorial, and the next, negative x to the 6 over 6 factorial, and so on so forth. As this sequel of graphs begin to approach infinity, the graphs create what is called a Taylor series. It's where regular polynomials go to become something different and something more obsolete. In this Taylor series, y equals cosine x encapsulates all the functions that were just mentioned. The Taylor series can be thought of as a movie, the points of the graph being the frames, the graphs being the scenes, and finally, well, the Taylor series being the whole movie.
When James Gregory wrote about a couple of his Maclaurin series discoveries in the late 17th century, it sparked some inspiration in Brooke Taylor to go out and actually create a method for this idea. A couple decades later, Brooke Taylor's method, which is now called Taylor series, became a vital component to understanding how approximations occur. The Taylor series is a way to express non-polynomial functions with polynomials. This not only allows people to calculate pretty good estimates for their non-polynomial functions, but it also entails what a graph's behavior looks like between a limited interval. Nonetheless, the mathematics behind the Taylor series works by plugging in the respective derivatives from the desired function in order to get the coefficients, but then dividing those coefficients by factorials to cancel out the numerous of times the power rule was applied. Doing this over and over again fits neatly into a sigma notation. This organized way of potentially representing millions of functions are all working together and are all harmonized. Connecting in this way, X and Y transform, allowing them to expand their abilities, grow together, and create new memories as they go. X and Y have told many stories. The Taylor series is just one of them. Before I go, let X be the rhythm of time, and let Y be your creative mind. Make each individual frame count, and create something beautiful. Make your own story. Thank you.